A fairy tale, a mystery, a horror story, Lucile Hadžihalilović's 2004 debut feature is quite possibly all of these things, yet still entirely its own creation. And a myth of female creation, even more perverse beneath the surface than it first appears. But first, that surface, into which a coffin emerges from subterranean passageways, into a boarding school within a vast forest. Inside the coffin, a young, live girl is taken in by her classmates of differing ages and a series of rules explained to her. There is no contact with family or the outside world, and no way to leave. The adult staff, primarily two young teachers, instruct them almost solely in nature and biology, and in dance. As they grow older, the girls will perform a dance routine, eventually leave their cloistered home, and go where? Despite the bucolic setting and air of sisterhood, from the outset, Hadžihalilović alerts us to something deeply unsettling. It's in the claustrophobic, largely fixed framing that rarely shows the sky, or the tight editing rhythms that enforce rigidity. These girls inhabit an idyllic-looking prison. Their lives are inflexible and hierarchical, with no encouragement for independence. Tu sais, c'est peut-être difficile à comprendre, mais l'obéissance est le seul chemin qui mène au bonheur. They're being prepared, groomed even, for appraisal and selection, and hints and allusions as to by whom and for what that might be are sinister in the extreme. Innocence is based on the 1903 novella Minnehaha, or The Bodily Education of Young Girls, by German writer Frank Wedekind, best known for his scandalizing and often revived play on burgeoning teen sexuality, Spring Awakening. Minnehaha does have parallels, though it's more suggestive, and Hadžihalilović's adaptation opens up Wedekind's world to even more symbolic potential. In visualizing vulnerable young girls, particularly their bodies this way, Innocence treads a fine line between examining and trading in voyeurism. Anyone familiar with the director's body of work, in feature and short film, will recognize her repeated fascination and negotiation with ideas of nature, sexuality, exploitation. Particularly in Innocence's follow-up and gender-flipped mutant twin, Evolution. Yet Hadžihalilović is always attuned to her young charges, to their confusion and acquiescence, defiance and desperation, the emotional and physical price they pay, and how the system ruthlessly deals with any divergence. If Innocence is an allegory on young girls growing up in a world that wants to limit and control them, it's more a sensual exploration of this than a political indictment. Hadžihalilović can highlight injustice and yet somehow seem ambivalent about how human beings fit into a natural world that survives on order and dominance. She dispassionately studies the women complicit in this power structure and even embraces the ambiguity about her young protagonist's future, offering no easy reassurance or release. Innocence is an immersion of both its characters and audience into a beautiful nightmare of fetishized desire. Its true transgression is to ultimately ask, just whose desire here do we experience?